comes, he remains God. That's the reason why today I want to speak about unchanging God. God who does not change, unchangeable God. Sometimes we change in our lives. We change because of things that happen around us. Sometimes our moods change because of things that are happening around us. Sometimes our lives change because of what is happening around, because of the environment around us, because of the things, the culture, the things of the world. So that will make us change wherever we are. But one good thing that I want us to know and remember today, that there's nothing at all that changes God. He remains God. And God does what he says he will do. When he says he will heal you, he will heal you. When he says he will give you something, he will give you. And God does things that man cannot do. And so that's why I want us to be encouraged this afternoon. That God remains God in our lives. God remains God in our situations, in our environment. So there's nothing that can change. Your problems cannot change God. My problems cannot change God. Can't change him from doing what he has purposed to do. He will do it because he's God. He's a faithful God. And that purpose remains God's purpose in our lives. And that's why when Jesus came to save this world, there was nothing completely that would change Jesus from saving the world, from the purpose that had brought him to save this world. So I want us to be encouraged this afternoon that there's nothing, completely nothing at all, that will change God. He remains God. And that's why it's a big miracle for all of us, IFC, in another French church, for us to be here in this place. It is because God has remained God in what he promised to do in our lives. Mm. He has remained God. And we cannot doubt him. We can live to worship him and to glorify him and to give him all that we have and all that we can do because he's God. And so that's why I want us to read in Malachi chapter 3, verse 6 to 12. Malachi chapter 3, verse 6 to 12. I want us to be encouraged there, a few verses there, and see what God is telling us.
I'll read in the name of the Lord.
Yes, please, go ahead.
For I am the Lord, I change not, therefore you sons of Jacob are not condemned. Even from the days of your fathers, you have gone away from my ordinances and have not kept them. Return unto me, and I will return unto you, saith the Lord of hosts. But you say, wherein shall we return? Will a man rob God? Yet you have robbed me. But you say, wherein have we robbed you? In tithes and offering.
You can't use it for any other, you can't exchange that word for any other word. us to lift up a hand. Now, we might have none of us doing that. And so God is speaking so clearly that we have robbed him. We have robbed him with our money, with our offerings, with our tithing, with our time, and with everything. But that does not change God, because he remains God. What he said he will do it. That's a good thing that the Lord is speaking. And I like what he says in the verse 12. And all nations will call you blessed, for you will be a delightful land, says the Lord of hosts. Why? Because you have stopped robbing from God. You have stopped robbing God. You have stopped stealing for God. And that is very important. And that's something that I want us to be reminded, because the Lord is unchanging his character. The Lord always keeps his promises. When he says he will do it, he will do it. The Lord's name is the name above all names. The name that declares he is able to do what he has promised to do for us. What he has promised to do for you, he will do it. When we return to the Lord, when we go back to him, when we return to him, we must give him all our life and all that he deserves in us. All that is needed from us that we are supposed to give him. And you know, when we are talking about this, we are not talking about the magic. We are talking about you and me. I'm talking about you and me. What have I done? And what have I given to the Lord? And what have I stolen? And how much have I robbed from him? And you know, to be called a robber, it is a serious crime. And so, but that's what the Lord says, that will not change him. He remains God, and he does what he has promised to do. God is unchangeable, but not in every way we might think him to be. Instead, he is unchangeable only in the ways Scripture tells us he is unchangeable, in his faith, attributes, purposes, and promises that he has met in our lives. So we can call to him. We can know that God cannot change. When he says he will bless us, he will bless us. So why can we give what belongs to him? What can we do giving what belongs to him? And you remember one day when Jesus was speaking, and the Pharisees asked Jesus whether it's okay for people to give to give taxes to the king. And he said, Do you have the coin with you? And he asked one of them, and they brought out the coin and said, whose face is it? And said, this is Caesar. And Jesus said, give Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and give God what belongs to God. So let's give God what belongs to him, and give Caesar what belongs to Caesar. And that's the reason why God is calling us today, that he is God and he remains the same God. And he will do what he has promised to do. And so that's why in Malachi 3, in verse 6 to 12, God is speaking so firmly to the Jewish.